Thank you.
And as a symbolic launch of our book, I'm going to give the first book to one of our own educators, Samuel.
Thank you, Dr. Sumai. Thank you. In the summer of 2015, I was teaching in South Korea with my family. I had the good fortune, through local contacts, to meet the percussionist from Yo-Yo Ma's Silk Road Ensemble, Mr. Dongwon Kim. The first time I saw him perform, it was wonderful. He performed a traditional Korean piece called Aryang. It's known throughout South Korea. He performed it on a traditional drum called a chungul. Now, not only did his performance reduce the entire audience to tears, as they all sang along, but I did not know how to respond. It was such a powerfully unifying performance, I had to know more. Fast forward to me traveling down the road with Dongwon Kim to a workshop in South Korea where he said he was going to teach me traditional Korean chungul. And then 30 minutes into the journey, he turns to me and he says, "Is that the only gear you're going to bring?" I said, "Yes, I've got my manuscript notebook, my field recorder, and I've got my backpack. I'm good. Friday evening, we'll be home." "Yes, you'll be back next Friday evening. It's a week-long workshop in a remote village of South Korea." I just failed my ATL of self-management. After calling my wife to say, "Honey, I'm going to be a little later than we planned. Can you watch the boys for another week for me? I'll be back next Friday," I was forgiven and I was on my journey to study South Korean music. I then learned that many of the participants in this workshop, I would be the first foreigner that they would possibly have ever met, and that the entire workshop would be conducted in Korean. My communication skills were about to be tested. But in Korean music, all of the patterns and drums, the drum rhythms, they're taught in such a way that they use dances and songs to communicate them. Dances are normally accompanied by sounds such as tong, 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 kung tak ta, kung tak ta, kung tak ta, kung tak ta. This meant I could join in with everybody else. And it's something I've since adopted in my classroom. Each day from 9 to 6, we would sit on the floor in the 40-plus heat, learning rhythms and drum patterns on the chungul. At night, I would sleep on a floor with 20 to 30 other men. It was here I had to develop some social skills, because at nighttime it involved drinking, eating, and singing songs to each other. We would all sit in a circle. There was harvest songs, party songs, and I, as an observer, I had to decipher what was going on. And it was here I realized everyone at this workshop had a rich, deep culture in music, a knowledge I didn't have. Now, it's at times like this, as educators, that we try to find something, a system, a scaffold, something that will help the learner construct some sort of meaningful opportunity. The difference here was, I was the student that needed support. I didn't speak the language, a little bit. I didn't have the knowledge, and yet I was loving it, because as a musician, I just wanted to get that drum, and I wanted to transfer all of his lessons and my ideas into performances and compositions. Why? Because music is like a language. You need to be able to speak it, play it, write it, and you have to make it up. But without the knowledge, it is very difficult. Teaching music for IB programs has given me this experience where I can recreate that immersive style learning in my classroom. And then with the students, we can build the knowledge and the culture together. To end this journey, I invited Mr. Dongwon Kim to my classrooms where he presented his children's book, The Birth of Korean Music. And then one more step, we commissioned a composer for the 2017 APAC Band Festival to compose a work that uses a mixture of traditional Korean rhythms as well as concert band. Through reflection, my pedagogy, my practice had to adapt. I connected my story through the context of music history and music theory, and I was going to challenge my students by adopting a more inquiry model of learning. Now, I've taught all three IB programs, PYP, MYP, DP, and I still approach my lessons like a primary school teacher. I value an active classroom, I value an element of choice in the learning process, and inquiry must be a common focus throughout all of my units. When I think of my experience in South Korea, not knowing the language, not having the knowledge, I then think of my year six students starting with me who may not know music. So the first unit I teach is math music coding, and it's primarily about numbers and patterns before the students see notation. I introduce them to the wonder of Fibonacci, and with our bodies and technology, we use that to create and apply what we know for amazing compositions. This here is the Fibonacci number sequence on the piano. 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21. And here it is all together. In grade 8, we undertake a unit called World Rhythms. Of course, we compose with Korean vocal sounds now, but we also go from YouTube-type tutorials where we use Brazilian percussion, Iraqi rhythms, and Turkish usul, which are a type of rhythmic cycle. It's all done through vocal patterns, dance moves, and then notation. The students engage with the material the exact way I did in South Korea. And then in the DP program, students are expected to have this diverse knowledge of music. Therefore, each of my units is structured around a theory of knowledge style question that forces students to think beyond a time period or a particular genre. So, I propose, Stravinsky is the Bach of the 20th century. Students then have to gather evidence, make assumptions, provide analysis that either proves or refutes this statement. By doing so, they're engaging in the very problem solving that is required by the diploma program, deep, conceptual, critical thinking. Another unit is called anime, where students must demonstrate the types of genres that go together to create what we know as anime. So through inquiry, we find out there's a recipe. And it goes like this. You take some rock, you take some jazz, some Chopin, some Ravel, and you throw in a dash of Stravinsky, and you have anime. It resulted in a fantastic student's extended essay last year, and this student's artwork, which is going to be published into an iBook with example compositions to help future diploma students. In teaching the baccalaureate, I now view my role as a teacher of problem solving. I am not just a music educator. my lessons extend into the very process of what it means to create. For example, here is a year 8 student's composition, played for you on the very drum that was given to me by Mr. Dongwon Kim when I did my workshop in South Korea. Yay, I like this one. Okay. The principle behind this video is something I model to my students. The teacher does the project first. Thank you.